Good morning and welcome to worship on this beautiful day. We are so glad to have you here with us this morning as we worship together, whether in person or online. Welcome. I also want to welcome anyone who is visiting with us today. It's our tradition here that if you are comfortable doing so, we invite you to stand and share your name and where you're from so we can celebrate that you are with us today. So is there anyone that, you don't have to do this, I'm just going to throw that out there, but. From Minneapolis. Awesome. Welcome. Anyone else? Yes.
We're visiting from Whitewater County for Ings.
Oh.
And we were here to do the wildlife craft.
Oh, wow. Wow. I'm impressed. Welcome. Anyone else? Well, welcome, and make sure you stay after worship. We have lots of things going on today, and you'll hear about that actually right now. So I'm going to invite Brad or Connie or both to come up and talk about God's work, our hands, which is today, you see from a lot of us are wearing our shirts. So come and share what that's all about.
Yes, we have a lot going on today, and I just want to mention how what a pleasure it is to work with your social ministries team. Very active organization or committee of the church, and it's just a real blessing to be able to work with that team. Some of the activities we have planned for us, for God's Work Our Hands today, would be the highway cleanup, if you're interested in that. After church service, we can meet out here under the trees, grab some trash bags, get a vest for safety, and we'll figure out how many people we have and kind of set some assignments for that. Quilters, as they perform God's Work Our Hands on a daily basis, are with through Lutheran Rural Foundation. Relief, yes. They're also going to be working on some quilts for Weave and some other local organizations as part of the this year's event. If you'd like to stay indoors, you can find the table in the back where we have addresses, members of our military, and some cards you can fill out for thanking those people who are serving in that role. Let's see, birthday bags for Weave can be assembled. Also another table set up in the back for that. The hospital has a healing garden which we started working on last year, helping them with this time of year, doing some weeding and some general cleanup. And if you're not prepared to do that today, you can work on that in the weeks ahead at your leisure. Just take your own tools and find your way through the healing garden and do some cleanup there. We've had a heartfelt discussion with one of our members here, Dr. Lisa Brown. A lot of the hospital workers are struggling right now, being overwhelmed in giving care to those in need. So we will be assembling some baskets of appreciation, thank you. We've got stickers to apply to some of these items. So we'll go in the basket that says, Custer Lutheran Fellowship is thanking you and thinking of you and praying for you. You can help with that assembly. They do really need our support. And lastly, we have lots of t-shirts you might have seen on your way through the Narthex. Please take some t-shirts home with you in whatever colors you might like. Pastor Phil loaned me one of his shirts. You can find it in all sizes, all colors, and help keep them out of storage. Let's see, I think I'm forgetting something. I guess not. Thank you.
will be, during worship, we'll be blessing some of the cards that you'll be filling out and we'll be sending to people, so make sure that's part of that as well. And again, God's Work Our Hands is something that is not just here at CLF. God's Work Our Hands is a national drive to service through the whole ELCA. So every ELCA Lutheran congregation in the country is taking part in God's Work Our Hands Sunday today. So I think that's a pretty awesome thing that we're part of something so much bigger than just us. So make sure you stay. And I would encourage you to take some shirts, take one of every color. I mean, we're trying to get rid of the shirts. Christmas gifts, I mean, you know. So come and be part of that. Just another note, we have this Wednesday begins our Wednesday night life activities. Yay! So we'll have Spark Kids at 4, and then the meal starts at 5:15, so I encourage you to come and be part of that. And then worship, a short worship service is at 6. This week we'll be doing prayer around the cross, which is one of our favorite services. And then at 6:30, we have a variety of things happening too. We have confirmation, choir practice is going to be starting up, and maybe rap group, if we have somebody to lead that. So come and check out what happens on Wednesdays here. It's amazing and wonderful and chaotic, and just, it's God's work in this place. Finally, we're going to be doing our noisy offering next Sunday, because we have so much going on today. So make sure you bring your change and all that with you next week. We've decided to collect that money through the end of this year to help with relief in Haiti and with some of the flooding that's been happening in Tennessee and other places. So make sure you bring your change next week for that. Now I invite you to stand as you are able as we begin worship in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Here.
we are chosen by God to receive the gift of forgiveness. Through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, we know that is true.
Compassion. The Lord watches over the innocent. I was brought low. walk in the presence of the Lord, in the land of the living. The second reading this morning is from James 3. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers and sisters, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. For all of us make mistakes. Anyone who makes mistakes in speaking is perfect, able to keep the whole body in check with the bridle. If we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we guide their whole bodies. Or look at ships. Though they are so large that it takes strong winds to drive them, yet they are guided by a very small rudder, wherever the will of the pilot directs. So also the tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great exploits. How great a forest is set ablaze by a small fire, and the tongue is a fire. The tongue is placed among our members as a world of iniquity. It stains the whole body, sets on fire the cycle of nature, and is itself set on fire by hell. For every species of beast and bird, of reptile and sea creature, can be tamed, and has been tamed by the human species. But no one can tame the tongue, a restless evil full of deadly poison. With it we bless the Lord and Father, and with it we curse those who are made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come blessing and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this ought not to be so. Does a spring pour forth from the same opening both fresh and brackish water? Can a fig tree, my brothers and sisters, yield olives, or a grapevine figs? No more can salt water yield fresh. Here ends the reading.
I invite the children to come up, and if you brought your backpack with you, bring it up with you. We'll have some stuff for you, and we'll bless your backpacks. You're looking all fancy today. Good morning. Good morning. How are all of you today? Good? You enjoying school so far? Yeah? It's good to ask you guys that, because if I ask the middle school and high school kids if they love school, they'll have to give me a different answer. So today, we are blessing your backpacks and blessing you as you go to school and start this new year in school, whether it's preschool or elementary school or whatever it is. And I have something for you, and it's a tag that will go on your backpack, or you can put it on your lunchbox or wherever you want. And it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. What does that mean, do you think? To love the Lord with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. What does that mean? Anyone? It's not a trick question, I promise. It just means to love everybody. It's not that hard. I mean, it's hard to love everybody, but so what Jesus is talking about when he says this is that we are to love the Lord your God, so love God, love Jesus with everything you have, with your head, your heart, your soul, everything. Love Jesus with everything you have. And to love your neighbor as much as you love everybody else. So who is a neighbor? Is it just the people who live next to you? Yeah? So people who live next to you. So can your neighbor be somebody at school? Whether they live next to you or not? Can your neighbor be somebody on the other side of the world? Yeah. So when Jesus talks about our neighbor, Jesus means everybody. So Jesus asks us to love Jesus and love everybody. Okay? So this is a reminder for you to do that. So you can take this with you and you put your name on it and have these on your backpacks, so I'm going to give each of you one of these, but I also have something for your parents. So, one of those. So your parents are going to be getting, or I'll give these to you too. This is what you use to hook it onto the, your mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, they can help you with that. So these cards are for your parents. So you give these to your parents or your grandparents or whoever. And these cards are for your parents or grandparents to give to you throughout the year. So these are things that will help you remember that Jesus loves you and Jesus loves your family. And just ways to help you remember all year long, all school year, that Jesus is with you at school and at home and everywhere. So I'm going to give each one of you a card that you give it to your parents, and you, as parents, grandparents, you give them to your kids. You can put them in their backpacks, you can put them in your lunchbox, put them on their dresser or something at home. Just different months of the year, just give them these, and as a reminder that Jesus is with them and Jesus loves them. Now, what did I do with my paper? Now, we're going to bless these children and bless their backpacks. Even though your backpacks are at home, we're blessing them anyway, okay? So let's pray. Oh, and adults can bring their backpacks and their bags too and get a blessing. Do you want a tag for yours too? I think you should. It's not fair for the kids to have these, and Mrs. Heine doesn't have one either. Right? You can have a card too. Maybe Augie can put those in your lunchbox. So let's pray. Dear God, as we start another year in school, we ask your blessing on these backpacks, and especially on these children and adults who will wear them, as they do the very important work of being students. Bless them with eagerness to learn, that their world may grow large. Respect for teachers and students, that they may form healthy relationships. Love for nature, that they may become caretakers of your creation. Happiness when learning is easy, and stick-to-itiveness when it is hard. Faith in Jesus as their best teacher and closest friend. Now I invite you to join me in the next part of the prayer. Read with me on the screen. We ask that you would protect these, we ask that you would protect these, your own children. Watch over them and keep them safe as they travel to and from school. As they learn, help them also to discover the different gifts that you have given each one of them to be used in your work in the world. As they hear the many voices that will fill their days, help them to listen most carefully for your voice, the one that tells them you will love them always, no matter what. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So thank you for coming up. Make sure you take your backpack tag and your cards with you, and give the cards to your parents. And for anyone who did not come up or has kids or grandkids that you would like to have a tag and some cards with you, I'll bring these out and leave them out in the narthex for you. Now we also want to, put this over here. We also want to bless our teachers, because our teachers play such a huge role in our children's lives. So if we have any teachers in the room, or staff that work at the school that would like to stand up and be blessed, you may do that, or if you're not comfortable doing that, you can stay seated. We'll bless you anyway. So, and we'll bless all the teachers and staff and administration and all the schools. So please join me in the prayer for the teachers. Dear God, thank you for these amazing teachers who have given their lives to serve our children. As they prepare for the new year, fill them with strength to lead, grace to guide, and hope to thrive in the contest. Bless them beyond measure for their willingness to pour into the next generation through education. Amen. Thank you. And we'll, proclamation.
Tells the other to shut up three times.
It's not something we would equate with Jesus very often, you know, that we tell that he tells people to shut up, or that other people would tell him to shut up. But really, that's what's happening. And I don't blame Peter for that. You know, Peter wants to stop Jesus from this crazy talk of his suffering and death. I mean, he doesn't want to hear his friend talk about that. After all, Peter says just that verse before, Peter confesses that Jesus is the Messiah, the one that the Israelite people, the Hebrews, have been waiting for forever. He's the one. He's the one that will save them. But that's true, but not in the way that most of them thought. The Jewish people at the time were waiting for this Messiah who would be this warrior king that would come in with an army and overthrow the Roman government and free all the Israelites, and they would have their holy land again, and they would be free. They were looking for someone like King David to come in with his spear and his sword and conquer. Well, of course, that's not who Jesus is. That's not who he was. Jesus upended everything that was expected of the Messiah. And some people were not happy about that. Nowhere in the Gospels does Jesus say, "It is my responsibility to die for you, and it is your responsibility to applaud for me like a hero." That's not who Jesus is. Instead, Jesus says, "The Son of Man must undergo great suffering, be rejected by everyone, and be killed." Oh, and by the way, so will you. So who's coming with me? Thinking the disciples are thinking, "I don't think so. That's not who we want you to be. And that's not who we think we should be." Like Peter, though, and the disciples, how many times do we want to pretend that Jesus did not actually say these things? Not that part about him suffering and dying. I think we can deal with that. But we don't want to hear the part about our suffering and dying. We don't want to hear that. We don't want to hear that that's part of being a disciple. Jesus is telling and asking his disciples to put their very lives on the line for him, to put all their trust in him, to stake their lives on him. And you know what? He asks the same of you and I. Do we stake our lives on Jesus? Do you and I put all of our trust and hope in Jesus? I think too often we put our trust in other things, and you can come up with a list of all the things that we put our trust in. I think sometimes our bank accounts are one of those things. We put our trust in money or our things. We put our trust in the politicians and the government to fix our problems. We put trust in our accomplishments. We could say, "I've done this," or "I've achieved this." Those things are not where we should be putting our trust in. Jesus tells us those things are not the way to follow him. We know the way, don't we? Remember the Gospel of John? Jesus says, "I am the way and the truth and the life." Eternal, abundant life that Jesus wants for all of us does not happen just after we die. I talk about this at funerals a lot. I talked about it at Janet Wellington's service this week. We have Jesus' abundant life now. May not seem like it sometimes when we feel like we're in the midst of the darkness of a pandemic or darkness of health issues for ourselves or people we love, or the darkness of natural disasters like earthquakes and hurricanes, forest fires, all those things. But again, we have Isaiah's assurance that God's love surrounds us, and that God is the one who sustains us and allows us to walk through those things. like the disciples, Jesus is asking you and I, who do you say that I am? Do we say that Jesus is a prophet? He is a king? He is a good moral man and we should emulate him and follow him? No. We say, Jesus, you are my way and my truth and my life. And all the other disciples here and around the world will walk that path with us, all of us together. But Jesus always remains in the lead. So today, especially as we, after worship, go out and do all these things to serve the people in the Custer and around the world, especially through the quilters, let's remember who we are doing it for and why. Who do you say that Jesus is? Jesus is our way and our truth and our life, always. Amen. Thank you.
Intercedes for us,
fires, and other disasters, especially to the people of Mexico who suffered through an earthquake this week.
Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh, Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh,
protecting God, you desire all people to live in peace and safety. Provide for all who are in danger. Strengthen first responders to help meet the complex needs of others. Provide care and compassion as they face trauma themselves. We pray on this 20th anniversary of the September 11th attacks for all who died, all who responded and worked to save lives, and all those who continue to live with the scars of that day, both physical and emotional. Help us to remember that hate is never the answer, and that your love is what sustains us in our pain.
Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh, Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express.
Transforming God, you announce release to the captives and freedom to the oppressed. Break chains of discrimination and injustice. Amplify voices that go unheard and inspire us to advocate for those who are overlooked. Give strength and healing to all who are suffering in any way today, especially those we name aloud or in our hearts.
Intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh, Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh,
forming God, you gather this community together. Shape our communal life, that in our prayer, praise, and worship, we honor you and encourage one another. Keep our disagreements civil and increase our joy in working together. Help us to remember that you are always with us, filling us with your love and grace. Give us strength to follow your way, your truth, and your life, and keep you first in our lives.
Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh, Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep or words to express. Oh,
loving God, bless this and all congregations as we celebrate God's work our hands today. Bless these cards that will be written and all the ministry and service being done today here and around the country. Bless the hands, feet, and hearts of all who serve your people out of love.
The Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep and words to express. Oh, Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep and words to express. Oh,
receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Always welcome at Christ's table. You may be seated.